I'm excited that we've made it to the last Sunday of the year. I pray that you had a blessed Christmas, and in case you didn't know, you are at First Reformed United Church of Christ here in the city of Lancaster, Pennsylvania, where we are an open and affirming church, which means we are a sanctuary for all. So this is a new thing I want to do in 2022. So like when I do the welcome, I'll say, and we are a sanctuary for y'all got it. Y'all got it. So every now and then, if I say it, y'all make sure we say we're a sanctuary for all. And that means whoever you are and wherever you are on life's journey, you are welcome and you're loved at First Reformed Church. And I love the Sunday after Christmas because that's the one Sunday I dress down a little bit. So I can get away with wearing my slacks. And I said, the Sunday I dress down, Gordy would dress up. So, Gordy, you're looking fly today, brother. You're looking fly today in your tie. Amen. Do we have any announcements this morning?
Sometimes they don't get anything to eat on Christmas Day. So we were there for them, which they really appreciate. They're always saying thank you. And we enjoy doing it. Thank you.
Yeah, I prayed for a white Christmas and we got a wet Christmas, but yeah, we were in the rain serving breakfast yesterday. It was a blessed time seeing so many come through and just to be a blessing on Christmas. Go ahead, Teresa.
I know it's in the bulletin, but I just wanted to give you a gentle reminder. Anyone who has not picked up your poinsettias and placed the sheet downstairs, there were 14 poinsettias that need to be picked up today. So anybody that's here that hasn't gotten one and paid for one, please get it. And then we'll wait for the other people to come get theirs. And I want to thank everybody that sponsored poinsettias because it really did help to make the sanctuary beautiful for the concert as well.
And you did an outstanding job making it look beautiful. Thank you. Thank you. I said First Reformed Church does me the way people do fruitcake. So you guys don't want to take the poinsettias home. I got like 5 poinsettias now. They're like, Pastor, you can have my 2. Pastor, take my 3. Pastor, get the one that I left up there. So I got like 5 poinsettias. So if anybody wants an extra poinsettia, you're welcome to see Pastor D. Any other announcements? Good to see the choir downstairs today and the chime choir downstairs today. And you guys did a great job Friday night at the concert. It was a great time and people are still talking about how beautiful the music was that Larry and Debbie and our guest violinist did. Let's thank them one more time. All right, let us stand for our call to worship. Can y'all believe it's the last Sunday of 2021? Man. Wow. When Jesus is born to Mary and Joseph, when they present Jesus at the temple, when Simeon holds Jesus in his arms, when Anna recognizes Jesus as the answer to prayer, this very morning, in the future we cannot see, our opening hymn this Sunday is Good Christian Friends Rejoice, and it's found on page 129. Thank you. Of the story we tell today, the encounter of old and young, Mary and Joseph presenting Jesus to the elders, we feel the movement of your spirit making all things new. Awake us to your presence in this moment as we seek Christ in our midst. Let us recognize God with us, a light to the nation, your glory revealed. In Jesus' name we pray. The Bible reminds us that the God we serve is faithful, and the God that we serve is just to forgive us of our sins. And every so often we miss the mark. We make a boo-boo. We make a mistake. But thank God that God forgives us and we can ask for mercy in the time of need. Let us say our confession together. Holy God, we know that you have been present to us throughout all of history, even throughout our own histories. We know you will be with us in our future, yet often we don't live as we know that. Simeon recognized in Jesus the salvation of his people. We recognize Jesus' way, our own wholeness and health, yet we've often failed to follow. As Anna recognized in Jesus the redemption of her people, we recognize in Jesus God's saving grace for us. Yet we often fail to rejoice and to share this good news. Forgive us and make us wise and joyful and strong so that we may live in the understanding of your never-ending love. This is our prayer. Amen. FRC, hear now the words of assurance. The scripture promises that God will make all things new, and as God makes the year new, may we also be made new by God's love and forgiveness. In Jesus' name, amen.
Bethlehem and see Christ.
Christ, whose birth the angels sing, come adore on bended knees, God our world now entering gloria in excelsis Deo. Sounding good this morning. Well, there's a portion of our service that we all can participate in, and that is the passing of the peace. But before I do that, do we have any visitors in the church this morning? Would you wave at me? All right. So glad to see you. So normally what we would do is come and hug and kiss you, but because of COVID and another variant that they say is coming out, we can't do that. But what we could do is give you a fist pump. We can tap elbows. You can tap toes. We may even wave at you like we're from Great Britain. But with whatever we do, we're going to pass the peace to let you know that you're welcomed and loved here at First Reformed Church. So First Reformed, may the peace of Christ be with you. Let us share the peace of Christ. It's the birthday girl. Didn't I sing to you?
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
Good to see you.
Yeah,
how y'all doing? You good? Christmas. I thought she was going to play the piano, Timmy.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Okay, it's all there. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise him in the heights above. Praise him, all his angels. Praise him, all his heavenly hosts. Praise him, sun and moon. Praise him, all you shining stars. Praise him, you highest heavens, and you waters above the skies. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for at his command they were created, and he established them forever and ever. He issued a decree that will never pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth, you great sea creatures and all ocean depths. Lightning and hail, snow and clouds, stormy winds that do his bidding, you mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars, wild animals and all cattle, small creatures and flying birds, kings of the earth and all nations, you princes and all rulers on earth, young men and women, old men and children. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for his name alone is exalted. His splendor is above the earth and the heavens, and he has raised up for his people a horn, the promise of all his faithful servants of Israel, the people close to his heart. Praise the Lord. I forgot to say, that was Psalms 148. The second reading is from the book of Colossians, chapter 3, verses 12 through 17. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive one another if any of you has a grievance against someone. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. Let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body, you were called to peace. And be thankful. Let the message of Christ dwell among you richly as you teach and admonish one another with all wisdom through psalms, hymns, and songs from the Spirit, singing to God with gratitude in your hearts. And whatever you do, whether in word or deed, do it all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. The New Testament lesson is from the book of Luke, chapter 2, verses 41 to 52. The boy Jesus at the temple. Every year, Jesus' parents went to Jerusalem for the festival of the Passover. When he was 12 years old, they went up to the festival according to the custom. After the festival was over, while his parents were returning home, the boy Jesus stayed behind in Jerusalem. But they were unaware of it. Thinking he was in their company, they traveled on for a day. Then they began looking for him among their relatives and friends. When they did not find him, they went back to Jerusalem for him. After 3 days, they found him in the temple courts, sitting among the teachers, listening to them and asking them questions. Everyone who heard him was amazed at his understanding and his answers. When his parents saw him, they were astonished, and his mother said to him, "Son, why have you treated us like this? Your father and I have been anxiously searching for you." "Why were you searching for me?" he asked. "Didn't you know I had to be in my father's house?" But they did not understand what he was saying to them. He went down to Nazareth with them and was obedient to them. But his mother treasured all these things in her heart. And Jesus grew in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and man. This is the reading of the word.
Thanks be to God.
We left Jesus in the manger. And then this morning we wake up in Luke chapter 2, and Jesus has bypassed puberty. He's already said his first word. Now he's in the temple at 12 years old, and his parents have left him. You know, it's a rite to call child services. Mary and Joseph left their child. And yet and still, he goes back, and you know the story. Timna read it, how he amazed the scholars. They were so surprised at how young he was. And you hear that infamous line, "I must be about my father's business." You guys know all that. But what happened before Jesus got to the temple? What happened before Jesus became 12 years old? What happened before he had his first word? Before he made his first mistake or boo-boo? You know, Jesus, he was like us. So he had to make some mistakes. He probably knocked over some vases and bowls and stuff, whatever. Here it is. I want to read for you Luke chapter 2. I'm going to begin at verse number 15 and stop at verse number 24. For our scripture lesson on this morning. In case you didn't know, the title of my sermon is, "'Twas the Day After Christmas." When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "'Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us.'" So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. And when they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them. After 8 days had passed, it was time to circumcise the child and to name the child Jesus, the name given by the angels before he was conceived in the womb. And when the time came for their purification, according to the law of Moses, they brought Jesus up to Jerusalem to present him to God. As it was written in the law of the Lord, every firstborn male must be designated as holy to the Lord. And they offered a sacrifice according to what is stated in the law of the Lord, a pair of turtle doves or two young pigeons. Pigeons. All right. God, let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in your sight. If there ever was a time I need you right now. In Jesus' name, amen. I saw this little poem for you, and I wanted to read it. It said the author is unknown, but it had my sermon title, so I thought it was cute. It says, "'Twas the day after Christmas, and all through the house, every creature was hurting, even the mouse. The toys were all broken, their batteries dead. Santa passed out with some ice on his head. Wrappings and ribbons just covered the floor, while upstairs the family continued to snore. And I in my t-shirt, new Jordans and jeans, went into the kitchen and started to clean. When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprung from the sink to see what was the matter. Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the curtains and threw up the sash. And when what to my wondering eyes should appear but a little white truck with an oversized mirror. The driver was smiling so lively and grand, the patch on his jacket said U.S. Postman. And with a hand full of bills, he grinned like a fox. Then quickly he stuffed them all in my mailbox. Bill after bill after bill they still came, whistling and shouting, he called them by name. Now Dillard's, now Walmart, now Penny's and Sears. Here's Boscov and Target and Marshall's all here. To the tip of your limit, every store, every mall. Now charge away, charge away, charge away all. He whooped and he whistled as he finished his work. He filled up the box and then turned with a jerk. He sprang to his truck and drove down the road, driving much faster, just half a load. Then I heard him exclaim with a great holiday cheer, enjoy what you got because you'll be paying it all year. I said, hey, if pastoring don't work, I can get a voiceover. I could work for Hallmark or something like that. But guess what? The day after Christmas, I found out, Bill, that the day after Christmas is called Boxing Day. December 26th is not only a day for Santa Claus to catch his breath, but a public holiday known as Boxing Day in the United Kingdom and in other British Commonwealth countries. According to history.com, in spite of its particular name, Boxing Day has nothing to do with fist kiss. It has nothing to do with the trashing of empty boxes left over from Christmas or the return of unwanted presents to the department store, but the term is a British origin, and an Oxford English Dictionary traces it all the way back to Charles Dickens, referring to something called Pickwick Papers. The exact roots of the holiday name are unknown, but there are two leading theories, both of which that are connected to having the day after Christmas. One of the ideas is this, is that December 26th was the day when the lords of the manor and the aristocrats typically distributed what they called Christmas boxes. And you could sort of see it like if you worked at a job and around Christmas time, the boss comes in and gives everybody a bonus or gives everybody a gift card. Like I gave all of our staff members gift cards for me. When you go in, that's what it was. It was Boxing Day. They would put little gifts. They would fill gifts or monies or even leftovers from Christmas dinners in those little boxes. That's one theory of what Boxing Day was. And then another popular theory about Boxing Day was that the churches would use that day to collect and give alms to those in the community on September 26th. Well, we're not in London. We are in Lancaster, Pennsylvania. And even though it is December 26th, it is Boxing Day at First Reform. No, we're not boxing like this. But as far as Boxing Day is concerned, there is a gift that we can share. There is something that we can give one another. There is something that all of us have and all of us can contribute and give. And guess what? It doesn't cost a lot. It doesn't require a lot. And you know what it is? It's the love of God. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. A lot of people are going to be upset coming the next couple of months because they're going to see those credit card bills. And they did all of this stuff to try to keep up with the Joneses and try to keep the kids happy. But the batteries are going to die. The toys are going to break. The shirt is going to get too small, Bruce. You got to understand that whatever the case may be, that the gifts are going to wither away, but there's one gift that will not change, and that is the love of God. Well, Pastor, you said you was going to talk to us about what happened with Jesus before he ends up 12 years old in the temple. Three things that happened with Jesus that can happen with us now as we begin to go into the new year. Three things that I see that took place with Jesus after his birth. The first thing is this: Jesus was circumcised. Let the church say circumcision. The men were scared to say it. Let's say it again. Let the church say circumcision. Jesus, Kirk, was circumcised 8 days after birth. Before he said mama or daddy. Get this, before he was even named. Before Mary and Joseph had even said his name will be Jesus, even though it was already prophesied, Jesus was circumcised, Judy, 8 days after birth. Circumcision symbolized the Jews' separation from Gentiles and their unique relationship with God. Circumcision today means giving up our sinful lifestyle. Circumcision today means I have to cut some things away. I have to take some things away. I have to remove some excess things. You preaching, Devin. I have to remove some excess things out of my life. And so that's the first thing that I want to share with you. As you get ready to go into 2022, is that the first thing that happened to Jesus, he didn't jump to the cross. He didn't go do covenant. He didn't serve communion. The first thing, Dean, he was circumcised. There was some stuff that was cut back, that was pulled away. And that's how it relates to our lives today. Circumcision is nothing and uncircumcision is nothing, but keeping God's command is what counts. But not only after Jesus' birth was Jesus circumcised, and circumcision means it was a setting apart, but the second thing that I see that happened with Jesus was that there was a consecration. Let the church say consecration. Consecration. It says that after Jesus was circumcised, you read it, I read it to you, Jesus was presented to God. Y'all saw the Lion King? You know, and then, just like that. Jesus, that was good. Jesus was presented to God 1 month after his birth. The ceremony included buying back or redeeming the child from God through an offering this way. And the parents acknowledged that the child belonged to God. It was a consecration. And the first of the year, since I can remember, I have always done a consecration. It's called a Daniel fast. And what I do is I give up meat, sweets, junk food, wine. I give up cigars. I give up watching certain things on TV for 21 days. I make sure it's over before my birthday. But for 21 days, I fast from January 1st to the 21st. And if you want to fast with Pastor D, just email me, say, hey, I might do the fast with you. Maybe you can give up the Young and the Restless for a week. Maybe you can give up drinking coffee for a week. Maybe you can give up Mountain Dew for 21 days. But I want to consecrate myself so that when I go into the new year, I have clarity, I can hear from God, and I know what is expected of me, not just as your pastor, but as a man and child of God. So first there is a circumcision. There's a removal of some excess stuff. And we can all be honest in here. There's some stuff that we could remove out of our lives or improve on. Improve my attitude, God. Give me some more patience. Bridle my tongue. Make sure that the words that come out are not offensive. And if they are offensive, let there be grace so that I can apologize and they could receive it, vice versa. There was circumcision and then there was consecration. But the last thing that I see here is that there was also what we call covenant that was established. And when I got to First Reformed Church, the main thing the Penn Central stressed to me, the main thing the Lancaster Association stressed to me, Carrie Carr, Chris Rankin, Dana, all of them stressed to me, they said, we are a covenantal type of religion, which means we don't go by a creed or by rules, but we are covenant, which means we go into an agreement with one another. So after you guys voted and I sat down, you know what covenant, when you guys get married, that's a covenant that's established. When I joined this church, they gave me the contract, but also it said at the top, covenant, because now I go into covenant with the church, I go into covenant with God, I go into covenant with the association, I go into covenant with the Penn Central. We're all in covenant together, even though it may not seem like it sometimes, but we're all supposed to be in covenant. I know they might be watching, so I guess we all going to be together in covenant. We want to be with y'all in covenant. We want it to be united Church of Christ. That's what we want. And yet, and still, it's hard to have covenant with conflict. Amen, lights. Thank you. It's hard to have covenant when people are critical or criticize or don't give any opening to it. And Jesus shows you and I, before he gets to the temple and is amazing the scholars, before Jesus says his first word, I wanted you to see these little things that took place in Jesus' life that prepared Jesus for where they were going. So before we cross over into 2022, what do you need to cut out of your life? What do you need to improve on? Before we go into 2022, how am I going to consecrate myself to go into the new year? Maybe me and my husband or wife or me and my partner will pray in the mornings now instead of fussing. Maybe I'll skip that cup of coffee or I'll forego drinking that beer this 1 week just to consecrate myself. And it's all to do what? Establish a covenant. And it's a covenant that lets you and I know that regardless of what we may do or say, there is nothing that can separate us from God's love. So you see, beloved, before Jesus got to the temple, there were some things that took place in Jesus' life that encourages you and I in going into a new year, that there's some things that we may need to cut away. There's some areas in our lives that we need to consecrate, but also we want to go into a covenant this year that we want to be better than we were last year. Maybe we went to church once a month last year. This year, we're going to go, next year, we're going to go 2 Sundays a month. Maybe I just prayed when I came to church. I'm going to do more of it. Maybe I didn't practice my music that Larry gave until we came to rehearsal that Sunday. I may practice it during the week. Whatever it is, follow Jesus. Before he got to the temple, he was circumcised, he was consecrated, and he went into covenant. And beloved, you and I too can do the same thing. Any prayer requests or joys and concerns this morning? Okay. Oh, I think Vanna is going to bring you a mic. Is Vanna still on Wheel of Fortune? Okay. I didn't know.
As you know, I'm not suing Bishop Hooper again. She is really
Will do. I know we want to pray for, I think the last name was the King family. I saw on the news this morning that a father and his two kids were killed in a fire. So we want to keep their family in prayer. They said the mother and the teenage son made it out, but the father and the two little ones didn't. So we want to keep them in prayer during this time. Yes, ma'am. Anyone else? We're continuing to pray for Rick, and we're praying for George Peterson and Linda. Let's pray, y'all. God of our weary years, God of our silent tears, we thank you, God, for bringing us to the last Sunday of the year. And God, we'll be honest with you, this has been a crazy year. We've had ups, we've had downs, we've had sickness, we've lost loved ones, we've welcomed new life. God, whatever situations or events may have transpired in our lives, we're grateful that you was with us. Whether it was the birth of a child or the burial of a loved one, God, we thank you that you was with us, that you was with us in new relationships, that you was with us in new fellowships, God. We thank you for being with us. God, so many are in need this morning. So many are down, are depressed. Remind us, God, that your son Jesus was and is the reason for the season. And that when Jesus came, Jesus brought us joy, brought us hope, brought us peace and love. God, help us to share that gift like Boxing Day, God, with our siblings in Christ. God, someone needs you to be a healer today. Someone needs you to be a provider. Someone needs you to make a way. So God, I lift up Deb and Darlene and Ron and Joanne. I lift up Kathy and Sue and Pat and Arlene and Kay and Yvonne. I lift up Ron and Janet and Janet and Janine. I lift up Dora, I lift up Shirley, I lift up Paula, I lift up Kathy, I lift up Noreen, I lift up Ed and Bruce, I lift up Ed and Dorothy, Alta and Don, I lift up Lisa, I lift up Randy Riggs, I lift up Rick, I lift up Brian and Paige and Diane and Pedro, God, I lift up Abby Schultz, I lift up Sean McNulty, I lift up Jackie, I lift up Bob Warmack, God, we lift up Mark, God, who's an intensive care in Virginia this morning, God. We lift up Susan and Jesse and Caitlin and her family. We lift up their cousins and nephews, God, that are dealing with sickness. God, we lift up Donna and we lift up Georgia. We lift up Marty and Tony to you, God. God, we thank you today for your love that binds us together. For your love that causes us to conquer when we feel like throwing in the towel. For your love, God, that gives us just a little bit more strength to go on. Thank you, God. I pray, God, that everyone under the sound of my voice, even those that are watching, that no hurt, harm, or danger will come to them, that they will go into the new year, that you will stop the death angel even now that would try to come. God, I thank you. And we pray the way you taught your disciples to pray in saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. It's now time for our tithes and our offering. God, we thank you for both the gift and the giver. And we thank you, God, that these gifts will be used to the upbuilding of your kingdom. We thank you that it will be returned not 30, not 60, but 100-fold. In Jesus' name, amen. Right, well, we have made it through the year. This is the last Sunday of the year, and so I'm excited. There was one thing I forgot to tell y'all Friday night. Where is it? So Monday night, we have leadership meeting, great meeting, and we leave leadership. I go on home, I go to the parsonage, and so I know I have my lights set on a timer. So I'm laying in the bed, and I'm like, I don't hear nothing. It's like, okay, well, whatever. So I went to bed. So I woke up, and I'm walking to the office, and I said, somebody threw a cord in the yard. I was like, why would somebody, ain't think nothing about it. Go on in. So then that Tuesday evening, my stuff doesn't come up. Somebody cut my lights. They cut and tore up my music box. They messed up the penguin, my inflatable penguin for Marianne Adams and my Christmas tree I bought. So you know, I'm talking to Janet. I'm like, well, I don't think I got any crazy exes in Lancaster. I don't think. And she said, I love her. That's why she has to stay the secretary. She said, no, Pastor, they wouldn't have messed with your lights. They would have did something to your car before. I said, well, thank you, Janet. I feel better now. She said, where are you going? I said, to check my car. So no, nobody did anything to my car. But yeah, they cut my lights, y'all. I was like, yeah, so I was mad. I was like, man, so I pray whoever took the lights, they get arthritis in their hands. I pray they get gout in their feet. I pray I was like, I said they skipped the gingerbread house, Eileen. They skipped Jesus in the manger and come all the way and cut my stuff. But yeah, it's all right. It happens. That's what happens when you're a downtown city church, that stuff like that happens. But yeah, it didn't steal my joy. That's why I came in here Friday night and sung till the roof started shaking, because I was like, you know, man, we're going to still have Christmas even in spite of. Our closing hymn is Hark the Herald Angels Sing, found on page 144. Crazy.
Thank you.
after the benediction and the postlude, you're welcome to come through the parsonage and grab a cookie. No, I don't have coffee and tea. Grab a cookie, and you can go through and see the parsonage. And maybe on in 2022, we'll have things at the parsonage like fellowship hour and stuff like that. But I did not want the year to go and you guys not see the wonderful home that you guys allow me to live in. I thank you. I thank you. I thank you. So please come through the parsonage and check it out. I have what I call the first wall, or my mother called it the Hall of Faith. But my first year at First Reform, I took pictures, and they're all on the wall. So some of you guys are up on the wall, so go and check that out. And my apologies, Friday night, I was reading the program, and I said, turn the page to Joy to the World, and wasn't no Joy to the World on the next page. So I said, I know somebody's going to holler out the hymn number, and nobody knew the hymn number. So Larry, I'm sorry. It was in the draft, but in between, I guess, Janet and I skipped out on that, but count it to our heads and not our hearts. Go in the love of the one who strengthens us for the work to which we are called. Go in the fellowship of Jesus Christ, who claims us as siblings. Go in the community of the Holy Spirit, who binds us together with all of the saints. But go into 2022 with grace to share God's love with all the world. Amen. Have a blessed week. Happy New Year. And you know I love you with all my heart and soul. Be blessed.